Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
Hello, my friend. All right.
Hey, look yonder coming, coming down that railroad track. Hey, look yonder coming, coming down that railroad track. It's that Orange Blossom Special, bringing my baby back. Hold that tiger. Ha ha! Well, I'm going down to Florida and get some sand in my shoes. Or maybe California. Good! And get some sand in my shoes. I ride that Orange Blossom Special and lose these New York blues. Say, man, when are you going back to Florida?
Well, I don't know. I don't reckon I'll ever go back to Florida.
But ain't you worried about getting your nourishment in New York?
Well, I don't care if I do die, do die, do die, do die, do die.
They talk about her rambling. She's the fastest train on the line. They talk about her traveling. She's the fastest train on the line. It's that Orange Blossom Special, rolling down the seaboard line.
Papa called a little boy Ned, raised him on the banks of a river bed. A houseboat tied to a big tall tree, home for my papa and my mama and me.
Yeah, the clock strikes three, papa jumped to his feet. He's already cooking mama something to eat. At half past papa, he's ready to go. He jumps in the pirogue headed down the bayou. He's got fishing lines strung across the Louisiana River. Gotta catch a big fish for us to eat. Setting traps in the swamps, catching everything he can. Gotta make a living, he's a Louisiana man. Gotta make a living, he's a Louisiana man. And here is the wild Cajun, the Kershaw.
Be done. He's got fishing lines from across the Louisiana River.
Here's a poem I wrote today to introduce our next guest to you. The hands of the baker and the candlestick maker are those of a skillful man. The thread of the tailor, the ropes of the sailor are tied by knowing hands. The watchmaker's eye and the light to see by, and hands that are calm and sure, make the tiniest springs do the tiniest things, and long has the skill endured. By plans well laid, the test of time will tell. But how can you count or know the amount of the value of a man? By the melodies played and the beauty made, by the touch of Chet Atkins' hands.
Would you tell that engineer to slow it down? Or better still, just stop the train, cause I want to look around. Eat your heart out, Red Lane. Hey, Porter, hey, Porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, would you tell that engineer to ring his bell? And ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell. Let's hear you yell now. Stop this train, I'm gonna get off first, cause I can't wait no more. Tell that engineer, I said thanks a lot and I didn't mind the fare. Gonna set my feet on southern soil and breathe that southern air. Ball, ball, ball. Songs of loss sometimes, because that's the way love is, and there ain't nothing any sadder than when love is gone. No one will ever know how much I love you, although a million teardrops start to flow. I'll cry myself to sleep and wake up smiling. I'll love you, but no one will ever know. I'll tell them we grew tired of each other, and that I was glad the day you set me free. I'll even make believe I never loved you, and no one will ever know the truth but me. It didn't work with our new love, and that our love was never meant to be. And I'll even make believe I never loved you, and no one will ever know the truth but me. There have been some great songs written lately by some great songwriters here in Nashville. Red Lane, Mickey Newberry, a lot of fine writers here. One of the finest wrote a song called Sunday Morning Coming Down. Me and Bobby McGee. Now he's got a great album out right away with 12 of his original compositions. One of the finest there ever was, Chris Topperson.
See him wasted on the sidewalk in his jacket and his jeans, wearing yesterday's misfortunes like a smile. Once he had a future full of money, love, and dreams, which he spent like they was going out of style. And he keeps right on changing, for the better or the worse, searching for a shrine he's never found, never knowing if believing is a blessing or a curse, or if the going up is worth the coming down. He's a poet, he's a picker, he's a prophet, he's a pusher, he's a pilgrim and a preacher, and a problem when he's stoned. He's a walking contradiction, partly truth, partly fiction, taking every wrong direction.
He writes a song about his Chris.
Lonely way back home. And shoot this word. Well, he's tasted good and evil in your bedrooms and your bars. He's traded in tomorrow for today, running from his devil's lord and reaching for the stars, losing all he loved along the way. But if this world keeps right on turning, for the better or the worse, all he ever gets is older and around. From the rocking of the cradle to the rolling of the hearse, the going up was worth the coming down. He's a poet,
he's a thinker,
he's a prophet,
he's a pusher,
he's a pilgrim and a preacher, and a problem when he's stoned. He's a walking contradiction, partly truth and partly fiction, taking every wrong direction on his lonely way back home.
Taking every wrong direction on his lonely way back home. Done good, Chris. To some of you watching tonight, perhaps you think that maybe your life has been simple and unimportant. You may have never done anything that anybody ever read about in the newspapers or
heard of on radio or TV. But still it's possible that the simple things that you've done in life might just be as important as any act of Congress or any order that was ever given by a king. To give you an example, here was a man. Here was a man. A man who was born in a small village, the son of a peasant woman. He grew up in another small village. Until he reached the age of 30, he worked as a carpenter. Then for 3 years, he was a traveling minister. But he never traveled more than 200 miles from where he was born. And where he did go, he usually walked. He never held political office. He never wrote a book. He never bought a home. He never had a family. He never went to college. And he never set foot inside a big city. But yes, here was a man. Though he never did the things that you'd usually associate with greatness, here was a man. He had no credentials but himself. He had nothing to do with this world except through the divine purpose that brought him to this world. And while he was still a young man, the tide of popular opinion turned against him. Most of his friends ran away. One of them denied him. One of them betrayed him and turned him over to his enemies. Then he went through the mockery of a trial and he was nailed to a cross between two thieves. And even while he was dying, his executioners gambled for the only piece of property that he had in the world, and that was his robe. When he was dead, he was taken down from the cross and laid in a borrowed grave provided by compassionate friends. More than 19 wide centuries have come and gone, and today he is the centerpiece of the human race, our leader in the column to human destiny. And I think I'm well within the mark when I say that all of the armies that ever marched, all of the navies that ever sailed the seas, all of the legislative bodies that ever sat, and all of the kings that ever reigned, all of them put together, have not affected the life of man on this earth so powerfully as that one solitary life. Here was a man. Thanks to all my friends that came by to make it so enjoyable. Try to be with us next week when our guest will be one of the top country artists today, Charlie Pride. And because this fellow was so great, last time we've asked him to come back again, Merle Haggard. He's going to be back again. Now, also that little 98-pound pack full of dynamite, Miss Brenda Lee. She'll be with us next week, too. Sound good to you? Sound good to me? Till then, I keep a close watch on this heart of mine. I keep my eyes wide open all the time. I keep the ends out for the tide of mine. Because you're mine, I walk the line. Good night, Bill Walker. Hello, I'm Johnny Cash. Hello, my friend. Hold it up, my friend, Martin. All right, we're going to take a train right now. Trip, I don't need no grip, I'm taking one more ride.
Way out there in the prairie air, I guess it's in my hide. Well, the clickety-clack of the railroad track is calling. If a man could know where the Santa Fe goes when she gets under steam, and the big loud bell at Bond's Farewell could hear her whistle scream, he's bound to go where there ain't no snow falling. One more ride. One more ride. Well, they gave him his orders at Monroe, Virginia. Said Steve, we'll win your eyes. Oh, this is not 38, it's old 97. You better put her down in the Spencer on time. Hey, then he turned around and said to his big greasy fireman, now shovel on a little more coal. And when we cross that white oak mountain, watch old 97 roll. We're gonna take one more ride. Hear me talking, one more ride. On a dark, stormy night, not a star was in sight, and the cold north wind come howling down the line. With his sweetheart severe, stood a brave engineer with his orders to pull old number 9. She kissed him goodbye with a tear in her eye. For the joy in her heart she could not hide. As the message she sent, and as her command went, tomorrow she'd be his blushing bride. There's a little white house I claim for my own, and I know that we'll be happy by and by. But I'll leave it to you, I know you'll be true, till we meet at the Golden Gate goodbye. We're gonna take one more. We're gonna take one more ride. Hear me talking, one more ride. As the years go by, I wonder why I long to leave my home. Hit the trail of the iron rail way out there alone. But my heart would sigh till I know that I am leaving. If I don't come back on a one-way track down to Mexico, find me there or any old where that a tumbleweed will grow. It's goodbye now, never know how I'm grieving. One more ride. One more ride.
One more ride.
Hey, Merle.
Yeah.
Remember our friend Bill Camel?
Used to rob, steal, and gamble.
Yeah, that's him. And on the side, he'd beg, so he cleaned up.
And I told him that he shouldn't do it.
And Camel told me that he knew it. So he started begging with a bucket instead of a cup. He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now. He didn't do like he should.
Yeah, but talking to him won't do no good.
He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now.
I met his old gal, Sadie. She said, have you seen Bill lately? I said, I don't believe that he's about.
Said, no, I ain't seen him. Well, she went down to the jail, but she went down to take him his mail. Then she whispered, Sheriff, please don't let him out. He's in the jailhouse now.
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 While Camel's put away, Sadie's with the sheriff every day. He's in the jailhouse now. Yeah, and I know a guy named Haggard. And late one night he staggered down the street and into a saloon.
I've probably been there.
The bartender said, go away. And Haggard said, I'm okay. You should see me stagger when I carry a tune. He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now.
He's in the jailhouse now. I don't know what happened to me, but they locked me up for slayed off keys.
He's in the jailhouse now. Good. Yeah. Merle Haggard.
Thank you.
you hear me when I call? Just tall, that's all.
Well, bad news travels like a wildfire. Good news travels slow. They all call me Wildfire, 'cause everybody knows I'm bad news.
Big boss man,
everywhere I go.
When I call.
Yeah, here when she calls.
Always getting into trouble.
Leave a little girl that I hate to see me go.
Well, I've been hearing stories how you've been moving around.
Well, I got no time to listen to that kind of hand-me-down.
Big boss man.
Bad news.
Why don't you hear me when I call?
Why don't you hear me when I call?
I said you ain't so
I'm just tall, that's all. From north to south, to east to west, the story is the same. From one state to another, I have to change my name, 'cause I'm bad news. Everywhere I go, everywhere I go, I'm always getting into trouble. Leave a little girl that I hate to see me go. Hey, Mr.
Yeah. I said you ain't so doggone big,
no.
But
that
you are tall.
That's all. Hey, it's good to have you
Thank
back.
Thank you, Johnny.
I'm proud to have you. Sure,
I am pleased to be here, and I got one thing to say to you.
What's that?
Big boss man. Hey, why don't you listen to me when I call?
Why don't you hear me when I call?
Oh, I said you ain't so big.
No, I'm just tall, that's all.
Yeah, you sure are tall.
You sure are small.
Oh, me.
Oh, me, you're tall. But you sure are pretty. Thank you, sir. Come along and ride this train. Cross the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. Ride this train. Ride this train across this great land that my father walked before me. Long before the poisoned cities, long before the white man came here. Ride with me along the rivers, through the green and silent valleys, by the great lakes of the Northland, through the mountains, moors, and flatlands. Ride with me to where the hunter moves in silence through the forest. Come with me to where the warrior walks with footstep quick and noble. See the children in the sunlight. See the children loved and wanted. There the woman, proud and quiet, moves about the doe-skin wigwams. See the old men in their wisdom sitting around the council fire. Come and listen to their counsel. Come and smoke the lighted peace pipe of the many tribes and nations. Mohawk, Mandan, Kickapoo, Cree, Yakima, Seminole, Crow, Shawnee, Choctaw, Delaware, Fox, Paiute, Winnebago, Cheyenne, Blackfoot, Navajo, Ute, Comanche, Quapaw, Creek, Apache, Sioux, Chippewa, Ottawa, Hoopa, Shoshone, Mohican, Osage, Menominee, Chinook, Arapaho, Nez Perce, Iroquois, Pawnee, Kootenai, Flathead, Chickasaw, Pueblo, Yuma, Pima, Pomo, Caddo. Then to this land there came the white man, in canoes as tall as pine trees. Strange their clothes and bearded faces, strange their manners and their customs. Get Your Money Told the Mighty, the Great Spirit, the Creator, sent a message to his people, and this is as he commanded. Let us welcome then the strangers, hail them as our friends and brothers, and the heart's right hand of friendship, give them when they come among us. For Seneca are an Indian tribe of the Iroquois Nation. Down on the New York-Pennsylvania line, you'll find their reservation. After the U.S. Revolution, Corn Plant was a chief. He told his tribe, "These men you can trust." That was his true belief. Well, he went down to Independence Hall, and there a treaty signed that promised peace with the USA and Indian rights combined. George Washington gave his signature, the government gave its hand, and they said that now and forevermore that this is Indian land. On the Seneca Reservation, there is much sadness now. Washington's treaty has been broken, and there is no hope, no how. All across that Allegheny River, they're throwing up a dam. It will flood the Indian country, a proud day for Uncle Sam. But it broke that ancient treaty with a politician's grin. It will flood the Indian graveyards. Corn Plant, can you swim? South Dakota, where the prairie grasses blow, the Minneconju, a band of Sioux, hunted the buffalo. Then came their hunters with their guns, settlers and their claims, and the Minneconju families were left starving on the plains. In the year of 1891, Bigfoot was their chief, and he promised his band of people to their sorrow he'd bring relief. For the government had promised him that if they'd leave their homes behind, new lands would be granted for as long as the sun would shine.
As long as the grass shall grow.
In the cold snows of December, they traveled to Wounded Knee, and there they were surrounded by the 7th Cavalry. Then the crack of a rifle filled the air. Bigfoot was first to die, and through the whine of the soldiers' bullets, you could hear the babies cry. The Minneconju were left dying, and frozen and bleeding limbs, while their white flag of peace still fluttered in the cold December wind. As long as the sun will shine. was a Pima Indian who farmed Arizona land, where the white man had stolen water rights till the streams no longer ran. Now Ira's folks were hungry, and their land grew crops of weeds. But when war came, Ira volunteered and forgot the white man's greed. There they battled up Iwo Jima's hill, 250 men, but only 27 lived to walk back down again. And when that fight was over, and when Old Glory raised, among the men to hold it high was the Indian, Ira Hayes. Back home, nobody cared what Ira had done. He was unwanted and alone. And Ira started drinking hard. Jail was often his home. He died drunk early one morning, alone in a land he fought to save. 2 inches of water in a lonely ditch was a grave for Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Of all the great tragedies of North America, perhaps the greatest of all has been the white man's treatment of his red brother. But with the coming of our ancestors to these shores, the great and proud people who had lived here for thousands of years were pushed back and reduced little by little to a state of poverty, grief, and hopelessness. Pushed back even to the very brink of extinction. Cast out of the mainstream of our society, the red man has become a stranger in his own land. Now, is it not time to think of these strangers here among us as our own brothers? Is it not time that we turn back to the message of Gichimanito, the great spirit of the red man, and do unto them as they were ready to do unto us? Let us welcome then the strangers, hail them as our friends and brothers, and the heart's right hand of friendship give them when they come among us. For
as long as
the moon shall rise, my brother, are you thirsty?
Charlie, you like Texas?
I love it, Johnny. I've been living there in Dallas since June, and it's real
good
fine
state.
I've been up and I've been down. I've worked the fields of clouds of ground. I've taken strain and pressure till I thought I might explode.
Now I yearn for dollar days of model planes and lemonades when the day stretched out before me like a long, long Texas road.
Yes, a long, long Texas road, about a million miles or so. When you're just a child, there ain't no time but now. Must have left that long, long road 700 years ago. And I'd find it once again if I knew how.
Take us to Galveston, Charlie.
Galveston, oh Galveston. Yeah. I still hear your sweet winds blowing. I still see her dark eyes glowing. 21 when I left Galveston.
Get your heart out, Glenn Campbell.
Galveston, oh Galveston, I am so afraid of dying. Before I dry the tears she's crying.
Texas breakfast is...
Oh, what's a Texas breakfast?
A Texas breakfast is a jug of whiskey, a steak, and a dog.
A dog? What's a dog for?
To eat the steak. She's my Texicana baby. Do I love her, Lordy, love? Her pappy came from Texas, and her mom from Arkansas. Winds me round her finger like a little piece of string. Yet I'm satisfied because she's such a pretty thing. If she hauled off and slapped me, I'd never feel a thing. She's my Texicana baby. She's my Texicana baby. Do I love her, Lordy, love? Her pappy came from Texas and her ma from Arkansas. She's pretty as a picture. You ought to hear her name. It's sweet as sorghum syrup and good old blue ribbon cane. She gives me lots of sugar and never spills a grain. She's my Texicana baby. It's a long, long Texas road, about a million miles or so. When you're just a child, there ain't no time but now. Must have left that long, long road 700 years ago. And I'd find it once again if I knew how.
Take us to West Texas now,
Charlie. Abilene.
Yeah.
Abilene. Prettiest town that I've ever seen. Women there don't treat you mean. In Abilene, my Abilene.
Hey, I want to tell you something. George Hamilton of the Fourth, who recorded that song, was on a show with me one time, and he was singing... Just before he sang that song, this fellow in the audience was hollering out, said, "Hey, sing Aberdeen, sing Aberdeen." He said, "Man, the name of the song is Abilene. Where are you from?" He said, "South Dakota, sing Aberdeen." Crowded city, ain't nothing free. Nothing in this town for me. Lord, I wish that I could be in Abilene, my Abilene.
Well, it's lonesome in this old town. Everybody put me down. I'm a place without a name. Just a walking in the rain.
I'm going back
to Houston, Houston, Houston.
I got holes in both of my shoes.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a walking case of the blues. I saw a dollar yesterday, but the wind blew it away.
Going back to Houston, Houston, Houston. So I watch the children play and dream my dreams of yesterday. Don't tell them to be grateful, I'm sure that they've been told.
If I knew then what I know now, I would have messed it up somehow. When the day stretched out before me like a long, long Texas road.
Yes, a long, long Texas road, about a million miles or so. When you're just a child, there ain't no time but now. Must have left that long, long road 700 years ago. And I'd find it once again if I knew how. And I'd find it once again if I knew how.
We're going to do this for Braxton Dixon. Keep your chin up, Braxton, not out.
I'd like you to make welcome my wife, June Carter. Hi. Come in.
Well, I'm gonna start out walking
just you wait and see.
Uh-uh, guitar picker, you ain't leaving without me.
Oh, you big mouth woman.
You long-legged guitar picker man.
But we can work this out. Yes, ma'am, I think we can. I stole the whole diamond, hoping that would shut your mouth.
Well, how am I gonna wear it if I gotta hide it?
Oh, you big mouth woman.
You a long-legged guitar-picking man.
But we can work this out. Yes, ma'am, I think we can. All right, Carl Perkins. First-class ticket on a luxury liner cruise.
I got out in that ocean, turned around, and there was you.
Oh, you big-mouthed woman.
You long-legged guitar-picking man.
But we can work this out. Yes, ma'am, I think we can. Oh, honey, I'm a big sweet mouth. That's all right.
You're a nice guitar-picker. You really are.
Yeah. Life is like a mountain railway with an end. Engineer that's free. We must make the run successful from the cradle to the grave. Watch the curves and heed the tunnel. Never falter, never fail. Keep your hand up on the throttle and your eye upon the rail.
Blessed Savior, thou wilt guide us till we reach that blissful shore,
where the angels wait to join us in God's grace forevermore.
You will ride a cradle of trial.
Say, when you park your car, don't leave your keys in it. Lock your car and take your keys with you so you won't give a teenager a temptation to steal a car. He went on to say that if you lock your car and take your keys with you, that it might help save a teenager from a life of crime. Then the announcer said, this has been a public service announcement. Was it? Huh?
Was it really? What about the teenagers? Do you think they felt a service had been rendered? My fellow adults, I think a disservice is done by saying such things. And don't you think teenagers will feel mistrusted and rebel? Then I saw a national magazine on the newsstand with a caption that said, "How to tell if your child is on drugs." Well, how about a story that says, how to tell if your child is confused? Or how to tell if your child needs help or understanding? And say, how about that generation gap we've been worried about? How about us trying love and understanding with the young people instead of judging them without a trial? This has been a public service announcement. Here's somebody you can tell them to pattern their lives after. Once upon a time there lived a man. Many years ago in a foreign land. Knew how to live right. Tried to be a light. Gave everybody a helping hand. I'm gonna try to be that way. I'm gonna try to be that way. Do the kind of thing a man ought to do. Say the kind of thing a man ought to say. I'm gonna try to be that way. He never done anybody wrong. He tried to help everybody along. He brought a better plan to make a better man out of the rich or the poor or the weak or the strong. And you know that I'm gonna try to be that way. Hey, hey. I'm gonna try to be that way. Do the kind of things, Lord, a man ought to do. Say the kind of things a man ought to say. I'm gonna try to be that way. And he preached love and brotherhood. He went around doing good, everywhere he went, they knew that he was sent, and the people started acting like they should, and I'm gonna try to be that way, hey, hey, I'm gonna try to be that way. Kind of thing a man ought to say. I'm gonna try to be that way. Yes, I'm gonna try to be that way. I'm gonna try to be that way. Do the kind of thing man ought to do. Say the kind of things man ought to say. I'm gonna try to be that way. I'm gonna try to be that way.
Rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. Ride this train. Ride this train with me through the stormy pages of history that were written by the mighty iron horse, the train. From the days of its birth, nothing has been so important to the growth of this country as the railroads. and the great locomotives that carried the settlers, their goods, and their dreams to the four corners of America. East, west, north, and south, the rails and the cross ties ran, following the trails of the pioneers before them, are breaking new ground for those who would follow later. The land was young, and so were the railroads. They grew up together. And the sound of that big eight-wheeler with their low, lonesome whistles forever became a part of the American dream. From the boat docks of New England to the California sands, from the coal mines of Kentucky to the Arizona Badlands, from the cities in the Northland to the rolling Texas plains, this land grew up with the coming and the going of the train. Some welcomed the iron horse, others hated it. Some prospered by it, others lost. See that young Sioux Brave sitting up there on that paint horse, looking down at those new shiny rails, those rails that have just cut his homeland in half. Put yourself in his place. I am just an Indian, but once this was my land. Now it's been taken from me by the coming of the white man. And anger makes my blood run hot and heavy in my veins. Every time I think about the coming of the train. In spite of the battles that were fought against them, the trains did come. They took root, and they were here to stay. Nothing could stop them now. Times were changing. And with the new times came new people, new ideas, and new ways of life. I'm an Oklahoma cattleman, have been for 30 years. Now the trains are full of passengers, with settlers stopping here. They string their bloody barbed wire all across my open range. And I'm fenced in by the coming and the going of the train. The railroads were the very lifeblood of the nation. Everything was sent by the rail. Timber, beef cattle, cotton, and grain. They carried dry goods, food, and water. They delivered the mail. Sometimes they even had money on board. Ask Cole Younger, outlaw, he knows. Well, the day was hot and dusty in the year of 69. As we heard a whistle blowing somewhere way down the line. That was the year I rode with Frank and Jesse James. And we waited for the coming and the going of the train. Yes, the railroads affected the life of every man, woman, and child in this country. From hobo to millionaire, Indian to cowboy, from outlaw to housewife. So important were the trains to the life of America that many people believe that because the North had railroad security already, the outcome of the Civil War was decided by that single fact alone. Anyway, it can't be denied that without the great days of the railroads, things would be far different than what they are today. Much of the country will still be a wild and unexplored place. Our great cities would not be here. And of course, none of the many powerful songs, stories, and poems that tell of the magic of the trains would ever have been written. Wabash Cannonball, Wreck of the Number 9, Orange Blossom Special, Rock Island Line, Wreck of Old 97, Freight Train Blues, Casey Jones, Moving On, and the Chattanooga Choo Choo. From the Carolina Seacoast to the Florida Lagoon, from the green hills of Montana to the dry Nevada sand dunes, from the Blackland cotton delta to Dakota's golden grain, this land grew up with the coming and the going of the train. This land grew up with the coming and the going of the train. Much of my own life has been affected by the railroads and by the coming and the going of the trains. I can remember when I was 3 years old. An uncle of mine let me ride in the engineer's cab with him down on the Cotton Belt Railroad in southwest Arkansas. That experience was such a thrill for me then that it stayed with me all my life. And even today, the sound of that low, lonesome whistle brings back memories of my childhood. When you hear that old train whistle going, what do you think of? To most people, it brings back memories of some forgotten yesterday. And though it may mean different things to different people, there's no doubt that on each of us, it's had a way of casting its mysterious spell. The drifter at the water tank, the crowds round the station door, lovers waving their last farewell, soldiers on foreign shores. The lonely poet in the night writing his sad refrain. Yes, they've all been touched by the coming and the going of the train. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Across the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. I know a land where mountain streams are running free. I know a prairie where there's miles between each tree. I know some people you would love to get to know. Come along with me and go. Come along and ride this train. Come along and ride this train. Across the mountains, prairies, reservations, rivers, levees, plains. Come along and ride this train. So long, Casey Jones. So long, Hobo Bill. If you've ever been in a country church, the sound of that piano will probably bring back some happy memories for you. That's the sound I had accompanying me the first time I ever sang in public when I was 12 years old, back at a little church in Dias, Arkansas. And here's the song I sang, and here is the lady that accompanied me on that song, my mother. They tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of a home far away. Oh, they tell me of a home far beyond the skies. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day. Through the unclouded day.